So when I originally came across yoga was actually about 12 to 13 years ago, when a friend of mine was kind enough to invite me to a class that she was taking. And up until that point, I had a foundation that was more traditional in functional movement and strength training. And I've always developed, or I've always had an awareness or key awareness of the approach and value that mindfulness and spiritual development had. Especially I felt like there was a undeniable connection to that in movement. So up until finding yoga, it was hard to find a way of moving that harmonized the idea of what those three things can be when they're combined until I found yoga. And, you know, like most, when I originally started yoga, I was very intimidated by how much I didn't know. You know, I thought it had more to do about mastering different asanas and poses. And you know, I was pleasantly surprised to find that that was just only a piece, or that was only a small part of it. And that yoga was more about allowing yourself to see yourself differently and taking a lot of the tools and lessons that you learn on the mat and being able to apply those tools out into the world, into your life, and to breathe more life into possibilities of what you want for yourself. You know, becoming a yogi isn't just about how you show up on the mat, but it's how you show up in your life. And I found that that was a page for me that I was excited about turning to, but more importantly, evolving into. So yoga became, from that point on, it always became something that I steadily used to go back. And whenever I felt, you know, lost, or whenever I met different points in my life where I felt like I was going against certain challenges and I felt like I needed to tie back in to myself, I would always incorporate yoga with meditation. And I found a way to always harmonize me back to my true purpose and my true calling. So since doing that, I've always spoke a lot of truth and value into the philosophy of yoga, and every day I try to make sure that I set aside a little bit of time every day to honor the tradition of yoga, even if I can't always find myself on the mat, but make sure that I honor the philosophy and the traditions of yoga through how I show up and how I treat others. So what made me decide to become a yoga teacher? You know, I think it was just being inspired by the people that I was coming in contact with and seeing how yoga was playing such a huge role in my own fulfillment and evolution. I've always believed that whenever you see something showing up for your life or showing up in your life and adding value, you should be committed to sharing as much of that as you can with other people. And in order to do that, it's imperative that you develop the information and the knowledge to be able to communicate that effectively. So when I started realizing with my private clients that there was an opportunity for growth, and I knew that yoga could be very healing in that way, I just felt like it was necessary in order for me to do my own due diligence and invest the time and effort to learn as much as I could about the practice. So my name is Faheem Abdullah Mujahid, and I'm a private yoga instructor that lives in Miami, Florida. The type of yoga that I practice is vinyasa power. I find that it not only aligns with my own private practice the most, but I feel like it's the one in which I feel the most connected out of all the other forms of yoga. So what I hope to be able to accomplish by not only practicing it, but using yoga as a tool to work movement and consciousness into the lives of the clients that I work with is I want to create an opportunity for clients to be able to reconnect with themselves, to be able to find that home that exists within all of us, to use the movement and its asanas to be able to unlock certain challenges that they have with being able to connect with themselves in that way. But more importantly, what I hope to be able to teach and impart on my clients through yoga is that yoga is more about how you show up on the mat, and it has to do with taking what you learn and being able to apply it in your life outside of or off of the mat as well. So how do I feel about the future? I'm excited. I'm excited to be able to use this beautiful tool, add it to a long list of ways in which I could connect and, more importantly, inspire. It's all about finding as many ways as you can to breathe more life, not only into your life, but into the lives of the people that you work with and the community. And I feel like there's no better way to be able to connect and to develop that than yoga. And I'm excited to be able to use the foundations of yoga to add value in that way. So I'm excited.